One of the most difficult balancing acts that a small shop will have to do is deciding when to farm something out and when to do it in-house. I have a milling machine, and while I don't have a lathe, I have an index and head that I can use good enough to bore a sprocket.
We have this Morris saw that cuts like butter. I know you've seen the video on that.
And we have this Lincoln MP210 welder, and you can tell by the amount of dust on it how much it gets used.
As a small business, you have to work smart, not hard. Do you have the time to do it? Will it look professional? What would it look like if you farmed it out? And most importantly, what could you be doing during that time to make you more money?
We can cut parts, and they can cut parts. We can tap holes, and they can tap holes. We can bore holes, and they can bore holes.
And the last one is a prime example of what small shops do when they don't consider farming out tasks. They push past the limits of what their equipment can actually accomplish, which leads to unsafe working environments.
Yeah, folks, and that was not an act. I was trying to bore the part, and that cutter was way too big for that Mac drill. They grabbed it, kicked it around, and yeah, hit me right at the stuff. We have been farming out our aluminum extrusion and framing tech for years. And you could argue that we pay more money, but they're always the right length. They are always square, and they are always tapped to the proper depth. And more importantly, we had a big quality issue in our panel building area with aluminum shavings. Even though we had a separate area where we did all our cuts, we ended up tracking aluminum shavings into it all the time. And you folks know, aluminum and electronics don't mix.
Plus, farming this out, we opened space up for other tasks. We farmed out the smart manufacturing cell, whereas our machine trainer we built in-house.
Both are top-notch trainers, but the lines on Framing Tech's design are much cleaner than on our machine trainer with its bulky gussets. It is what they do day in and day out, so they can accomplish this design faster and with less error.
You are getting ready to see us assemble this smart manufacturing cell. And what we found while putting this together is there were no missing parts, everything matched, and we didn't have a single part left over.
We have documented every step of this, from building the frame to the control panel to the programming and startup and commissioning. And we have collaborated with more companies on this than any project we've ever done. Amber and I would not have been able to do this without those collaborations. So as you watch this series and you're thinking that you need to do everything in-house, think about those items that you could farm out that would let you focus on what you do best.
Click here to see how smoothly Framing Tech's design went together.